Tikshaya Karunaya Miya Kila Jantushu Samatvena Cha Sarvatma Bhagavan Samprasidati Titikshaya Karunaya Maitriya Cha Kila Jantushu Samatvena Cha Sarvatma Bhagavan Samprasidati. Please repeat word to words. Titikshaya, by tolerance. Karunaya, by mercy. Maitriya, by friendship. Cha, also. Akhila, universal. Jantushu, unto the living entities. Samatvena, by equilibrium. Cha, also. Sarvatma, the super soul. Bhagavan, the personality of Godhead. Samprasidati, becomes very satisfied. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Prabhupada, Jai Srila Prabhupada. Translation. The Lord is very satisfied with His devotee when the devotee greets other people with tolerance, mercy, friendship and equality. Please repeat. The Lord is very satisfied with His devotee when the devotee greets other people with tolerance, mercy, friendship and equality. Purport. It is the duty of an advanced devotee in the second stage of devotional perfection to act in accordance with this verse. There are three stages of devotional life. In the lowest stage, a devotee is simply concerned with the deity in the temple and he worships the Lord with great devotion according to rules and regulations. In the second stage, the devotee is cognizant of his relationship with the Lord, his relationship with fellow devotees, his relationship with persons who are innocent, and his relationship with persons who are envious. Sometimes devotees are ill-treated by envious persons. It is advised that an advanced devotee should be tolerant. He should show complete mercy to persons who are ignorant or innocent. A preacher devotee is meant to show mercy to innocent persons whom he can elevate to devotional service. Everyone by constitutional position is an eternal servant of God. Therefore, a devotee's business is to awaken everyone's Krishna consciousness. That is his mercy. As for a devotee's treatment of other devotees who are his equals, he should maintain friendship with them. His general view should be to see every living entity as part of the Supreme Lord. Different living entities appear in different forms of dress. But according to the instruction of the Bhagavad Gita, a learned person sees all living entities equally. Such treatment by the devotee is very much appreciated by the Supreme Lord. It is said, therefore, that a saintly person is always tolerant and merciful. He is a friend to everyone, never an enemy to anyone, and he is peaceful. These are some of the good qualities of a devotee. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam yena tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. Namavom Vishnupadaya Krishna Preshthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swamin Itinamine. Namaste Sarasvate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschatya Deshatarine. Jaya Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Gadadhara Sri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Very nice instructions for, Prabhupada writes, for a second stage, for a devotee in the second stage of devotional service. Titikshaya karunaya maitriya cha akhila jantushu samatvena cha sarvatma bhagavan samprasidati. Bhagavan, the Supreme Lord, becomes satisfied, samprasidati, with a devotee who exhibits these qualities. What are these qualities? Titikshaya, tolerance; karunaya, mercy; maitriya, friendship; cha akhila jantushu samatvena. Akhila jantushu samatvena means equality, seeing everyone, all living entities, as part and parcel of the Lord. Sarvatma, as super soul is present in everyone's heart. Bhagavan samprasidati, the Lord becomes satisfied. So Prabhupada mentions that there are three classes of devotees, three stages of devotional service. In the first stage, even when we are initiated, our devotional service starts. We start off with being a Kanishta Adhikari. Kanishta means the lowest. Kanishta Adhikari means Archayam Eva Haraye Pujamya Shraddhayehate Natad Bhakteshu Chanyeshu Sabhaktaha Prakritasmrutaha. What it means? Archayam Eva Haraye. He does nice worship of the Lord. He engages in deity worship. Puja yashraddhayehate. He does with nice faith puja. But he does not know who is a devotee and who is not a devotee. Meaning he does not know how to respect other devotees, how to not associate with non-devotees, how to deal in friendship with devotees, how to see the Lord beyond the deity in the temple. So all these things he does not know. So in the initial stages of devotional service, that is called Kanishta. So one should progress and become more and more advanced. And the next stage is Madhyama. Madhyama means the middle, or second stage, where this verse is applicable, as Prabhupada is saying. There is another verse in Srimad Bhagavatam where a middle stage devotee, second stage devotee, how he deals with different kinds of people. Ishvare tad adhineshu balisheshu dvishat sucha. Ishvare tad adhineshu balisheshu dvishatsu. These four classes of people we interact. A devotee usually interacts with these four classes of people. Ishvare means the Supreme Lord. Tadadhineshu means his devotees. Tadadhineshu, who has surrendered to him. Baliseshu. Baliseshu means just like children. Bala. Innocent people who are almost like children, Baliseshu and Dvishatsu. Dvishatsu means people. So how does he deal with these four classes of people? Prema, Maitri, Krupa, Upeksha. Yah Karoti, Sa Madhyama. Whoever does this with these four kinds of people, he is a Madhyama. Yah Karoti, Sa Madhyama. What does he do? Prema. For Ishvara, he loves the Supreme Lord. He exhibits love. He tries to love. Manmana, Bhava Madbhakto, Madhyaji, Mam Namaskuru. Prema. Ishvare Tadadhineshu. And his devotees, what does he do? Maitri. Maitri means friendship. So here also it is there. Maitriya. Maitriya means he exhibits friendship. He develops friendship. Rupa Goswami further explains the kinds of dealings with fellow devotees in Nectar of Instruction. Six kinds of dealings. What are the six kinds of dealings with devotees one should do? Dadati, pratigrihnati, guhyam akhyati pruchyati, bhungte bhojayate chaiva, shadvidham priti lakshanam. Dadati, pratigrihnati means giving gifts and accepting gifts. Giving gifts and accepting gifts. Exchanging gifts. And guhyam akhyati pruchyati, revealing one's mind in confidence and inquire confidential topics. Guhyam akhyati pruchyati. And bhungte, calling devotees for prasadam and also going to devotees' home for prasadam. These are all wonderful exchanges. So these are the six kinds of dealings which form part of friendship, Maitri. So the devotee should have friendship with other devotees. So for the Lord, he loves the Supreme Lord. For the devotees, he renders friendship. And Krupa. Krupa means mercy. He shows mercy to whom? Baliseshu, or innocent people who are eager and ready to accept what we say, but who are ignorant. Ignorant can be two classes. One is Dvishatsu and one is Baliseshu. One who is ready to accept what the authorities say, and one who is not ready to accept, but ready to argue. They have their set beliefs. So these are the two classes of ignorant people. So if we find that ignorant person is innocent, Baliseshu, we should give mercy. Karunaya. Titikshaya Karunaya. Or Krupa. Krupa or Karuna, the same thing. So we should be going all out to help that person to engage in Krishna consciousness. Like when we go to book distribution, or when we find somebody in temple, or when we meet somebody outside at our work or some other place where they show interest in progressing in Krishna consciousness, we should show our mercy, Karunaya, Krupa, to bring them up from where they are. And for Dvishatsu, for envious people, Upeksha. Upeksha means ignore, leave them alone. And the other quality, important quality mentioned here, when dealing with envious people, when we are subject to so much of torture, that is Titikshaya. What is Titiksha? Huh? Titiksha means tolerance. Tolerance. Tolerance happens to be one of the first qualities Krishna mentions in Bhagavad Gita. after he mentions the 2.13, the famous verse. Who can say that? Dehinosmin yadhadehe kaumaram yavanam jara tadhadehantara praptir dhiras tatra namuhyati. So he says, who is a dhira means one who does not get bewildered by this bodily changes and who understands that the soul passes on to another body. And then he says, matras parshastu kaunteya sitoshna sukha dukkhada agama payinu anityas tams titikshasva bharata. Titiksha, tams titikshasva. So Krishna said, okay, the soul passes on to another body, but Krishna is not discounting the fact that that will produce distress. Yes, the soul passes on to another body, but the person who is related to him, obviously he is attached to that person. So he will obviously feel distressed, separation, disappointment because of that person leaving the body. But Krishna says, you should tolerate titiksha. So the titiksha has to be applied even in this case, when we meet people who may not be in the same, who may not extend a cordial relation to us, especially when we go out to preach or to distribute books, to raise funds. One Prabhupada's disciple, he was sharing his memory. He said, in those days, in 70s, they were all young people, 19, 20, 21, 22, predominantly Westerners, many of them skinny people, and they would look childish at times. And Prabhupada took many of them to India. And in India, the kind of program that happened and is happening now predominantly is life membership. They distribute books in terms of making life members. They would have to pay, I don't know, right now maybe it's 25,000 rupees for becoming life member. So they will have to pay maybe 2,000 rupees in those days. And then they would give some set of books and they become a life member and so forth. So these devotees were making appointments and going and visiting various places. And he goes and visits one place where there are not so welcome people. And they look at these Westerners wearing saffron clothes and trying to imitate like a sadhu unconvincingly. And they were not taking very seriously. They were not believing that they are part of Hare Krishna movement, the disciples of Swami Prabhupada. And so one set of people, they were talking to this devotee. And this devotee was asking, can you become a life member? And they said, do you know Mahabharat? He said, yes, I know a little bit of Mahabharat. They said, in Mahabharat, Karna was actually the hero. And he said, no, Karna is not the hero. Arjuna and Krishna are the heroes of Mahabharat. He has this Bhagavad Gita in mind. Even otherwise, Mahabharat, he says, Arjuna and Krishna are the hero. No, Karna is the hero. So there is a little bit of exchange of words. And the devotee seems to get a little agitated. And now they take the opportunity. See how you are getting angry, how you are getting agitated. This is what your guru has taught you. This is what your guru's teachings have done to you. And then this devotee was mentioning in his memory, if this was 1 year back, if this conversation happened before he joined the temple, he should have bet him, he should have hit him, that guy, instantly. But because he went through the training of being a devotee in the temple, trying to control his senses, trying to withstand the agitations provided by others, trying to tolerate all that, he was able to tolerate. And actually, he said they recognized that part. Even though they were trying to agitate him a lot, he was controlling. And they got impressed and became life members. So he was mentioning the practical application of the teaching of Kapiladeva here. Not Kapiladeva, Swayambhu Manu advising Dhruva Maharaj. Stitikshaya, very important quality for a devotee, especially when we go out in a zone where we are not comfortable, where we are at the mercy of the people who we talk to. And this devotee has another experience where he makes an appointment with a really big guy, a big industrialist, the owner of the Parley Group, where they produce these biscuits. And apparently they also owned a lot of this soft drinks, the Gold Spot. And if you remember in our childhood, we had this soft drink called Gold Spot. So they had Chauham brothers. So he made an appointment with them and he goes and meets them. He's a really big guy, wearing, you know, big suit, and in his chambers, almost like a Western chambers even in those days, and a lot of servants. But unfortunately, this devotee goes, he had an appointment at 9 o'clock. He goes at 9:08. And that the owner of the company, he gives an appointment only for 10 minutes. So he went at 9:08, and then the owner is there, and this devotee is charmed by all the opulent office that he has and the servants and the way he's dressed and all that. So he's getting a little intimidated. And then the owner says, I gave you 10 minutes and you already are late by 8 minutes. So you have only 2 minutes. So you speak whatever you have to speak in 2 minutes and you go. And so the devotee has this briefcase where he carries these books and life membership details, and he bangs the briefcase on his table, opens it and says, if you become a life member, you will get all these books and your life will be happy. That's the three statements he makes. I'm done. He's not even taking 20 seconds, forget 2 minutes. And surprisingly, the owner, he said, if you didn't have this profession, if you were not into this devotee profession, I would have hired you as my salesman. He was so impressed by the pitch that he did that he was immediately convinced and he became a life member. So these are the kind of the feeling of invincibility the devotees had. They were going everywhere, everywhere. The other time the devotee was mentioning, in New York in those days where they were having Radha Yatra, the mayor has banned any processions because of unable to control the crowds and lack of their resources, both monetary as well as people. They banned all processions for a while. And miraculously, this devotee, somehow or other, he got the permit for Radha Yatra. And Radha Yatra also happened. And then the devotees were wondering what this devotee has done. What have you done to get the permit? He said, very simple. I went directly to the main office. I said, we just need a permit, simple permit for our event. And what is your event? No, we are just hand pulling some carts. Then they thought some children pulling some carts using their hands, and they gave the permit. And that he took the paper and he went everywhere and they showed the police. And then they realized that, you know, this is the technique he used. Nobody knew that whatever he said. They just thought that this is some children pulling hand-pulled carts. So, you know, amazing things will happen if we just have faith in Prabhupada. These wonderful experiences the devotees. So, titikshaya, karunaya, maitya chakila jantushu, samatvena cha sarvatma. So, Prabhupada was his main. Yesterday, I was hearing a lecture where on the appearance day of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he said his Guru Maharaj, even though he built 64 Gaudiya Mutt temples, but at one point he was not very impressed with the kind of mentality of the preaching spirit of some of his disciples, so much so that he just wanted to sell all the marble of the temple and use that money to print books and distribute books. And that's what he would also tell Prabhupada every time. If you ever get money, print books. So Prabhupada was always behind book distribution. And of course, Prabhupada had other projects. We should always not also minimize the importance of other projects. When Prabhupada established Vrindavan Temple, it was in a very short time. He had very short time. He knew that he had to accomplish a lot before he left the planet. So Vrindavan Temple was one of the important things in his mind, as well as the Bombay Temple and Mayapur Temple. These were the three main temples that he took it very prestigiously. So after Vrindavan Temple was opened, for opening the temple, the devotees were going everywhere. There was this devotee, Guru Krupa Prabhu, who went to this place, Japan, I think. And he was working day and night for months and months without proper food, proper sleep, and working his skin out to raise funds for Prabhupada. And like that, there are many, many other devotees who sent their hard-earned money, time, and they sent the money to Vrindavan Temple. And then Vrindavan Temple got opened. And so Prabhupada was very happy. And the next day he was walking with his disciples. And he was saying how he was practically whipping all the disciples to get the money and the required, whatever is required for getting the temple. So that was just amazing. Sometimes, you know, in the heat of the moment, the devotees were trying to sell books in all kinds of possible ways. There was one devotee where he was explaining. He knew another devotee how he sold Chaitanya Charitamrita in South India. In South India at that time, there was this Christian missionaries. And they were making a lot of this conversion into Christians. And so whenever he went, he would meet a lot of these Christians. And so the way he would sell this Chaitanya Charitamrita is by saying, this Chaitanya Charita, he wouldn't say Chaitanya Charitamrita. This is a book about Christian Chaitanya. Because Prabhupada also used the word Krishna for Krishna. So Chaitanya is Krishna himself. So this is a book about Christian Chaitanya. And they would think that, oh, this is a book about Christian, you know, spirit, and they would buy this Chaitanya Charitamrita books. So this devotee wrote a letter to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, or devotees are using all these kinds of ways to sell books. So Prabhupada said, no, we should present the book by its own merit. So Prabhupada, of course, he commended devotees who were working hard in whatever ways to raise funds. He would correct them. He would say, okay, whatever you've done, that's fine. But try to sell the book on its merit. If you present it nicely, then they will get attracted. You don't have to do any of those things. So like that, Prabhupada was encouraging. I was also sharing recently an experience of two devotees, not experience, one store owner. He sees two devotees selling this Back to Godhead magazines and vehemently preaching Krishna consciousness, how, you know, this world is a place of disaster, dukkhalayam, ashashvatam. And so that store owner, it's a female, she writes a letter to Prabhupada. She is from a kind of another religious background where they preach love, mercy, you know, sharing, caring, all these material jargons, which eventually prove nothing effective in terms of changing our hearts, except talking nicely and being cordial. So she writes a letter to Prabhupada, "Your disciples seem to have a very negative outlook to the world. Why do they always look at the world pessimistically?" So Prabhupada takes time to respond to her. Very big letter. He writes a very big letter explaining how the devotees were right. But of course, initially he asks for forgiveness on the behalf of devotees, saying, yes, they might have been not very mature, but their eagerness is what we should commend. A person who has given up everything in this world and has taken to the service of the Lord, we should appreciate that person, because it is very easy to sit in the comforts of our home and family and get carried away by the senses. It's very difficult to get out of that situation and surrender to the lotus feet of the Lord. And then he goes on to quote Krishna in Bhagavad Gita, and where he says, "Mamupetya kaunteya dukhalayam mashashvatam." Krishna himself, the Supreme Lord himself, is saying, this world is a place of misery, is a place of suffering. So one should try to get out of this place. And that is what these devotees are doing. And your so-called love on the material platform is actually lust. You want to satisfy your senses and they want to satisfy their senses. Love can only happen in relation with the Supreme Lord. Like what this verse says. One should render love to the Supreme Lord. Ishvare tadadhineshu baliseshu dvishetsucha prema. One should love the Supreme Lord. So, a second class, a second stage devotee, Madhyamadhikari, he has to carefully cultivate these qualities for his effective preaching. Tolerance, mercy, friendship with devotees, having nice relation, and viewing everyone equally. Vidya vinaya sampanne brahmane gavihastini sunichaiva svapakecha panditaha samadarshinaha. So we should not have a resentment. Somebody rejects us during book distribution. We should go separately and we should talk to devotees. What this kind of... Of course, we can talk in terms of philosophy. This person belongs to one of these four classes of non-devotees. What is that verse in Bhagavad Gita? Four kinds of people never surrender to the Lord. Namam duskritino mudhaha naradhamaha mayayapahritagnana asuram bhavam ashritaha. Yes, we can talk about that, but not in a belittling way. Because a devotee should see equality. Samatvena cha sarvatma. As the Supreme Lord is there in everyone's heart. Years back, I had an experience during book distribution. We went to book distribution on, is it Halloween? Probably Halloween, yeah. Halloween, where the kids come with different costumes and they knock the doors and people open and give candy and all that. So we went to book distribution on a Halloween day and we knocked one door. One Indian gentleman, he came out with a box of chocolates and with his kids. And there we were in front of him saying, Hare Krishna. So we came from temple, distribute books. And then his face started turning red, became really ferocious. He's like, he lost his cool and started shouting like anything. What do you guys think? You know, you're causing a disrepute to your organization. You're coming on a day where kids are enjoying and you're causing disturbance to our society. This place is not for solicitation. You know, all kinds of things. I'll call the police right now if you don't leave the property right now. And I was right there in front of him. There was two more devotees. And there was another devotee below the steps. He got really agitated. What is your name? What do you... He was asking, he was trying to give back to this person. So we went and said, no, cool down. We need to tolerate. We said, okay, you leave the property. Sorry about what happened. You enjoy fun with your kids. And then we went, unless we get a second warning, we won't leave the place. So we went to the other block and we went ahead with our what we had to do. So the point is titiksha, tolerance. And for all this to happen, one should have very nice sadhana. For all these things, one should actively contemplate. And we cannot, even though we try to cultivate, we cannot artificially cultivate these habits unless they get unearthed from our inner core. So that cleansing process has to happen by sadhana, by actively praying. We have to pray to the Lord to give these qualities. Like Bhaktivinoda Thakur is praying, give these qualities. Ohe Vaishnava Thakura Doyara Sagara Chaya Bega Domi Chaya Dosha Sodhi. Like that, give me these qualities. Kabe Habe Bolo Sedina Amar. When will that day be mine? When I have all the compassion for everyone. Sedina Hrudaya. What was that last verse of that song? Kabe Jibe Doya Hoibe Udaya. Kabe Jive Doya Hoibe Udaya. When will that compassion for the living entities manifest in my heart? That means he is praying to the Lord. Earnestly praying, when will that day be mine, when that compassion manifests in my heart? The Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, he said two important things one should aspire for in devotional service. If at all, there is only two things that we should aspire for. One is to acquire taste for chanting the holy name of the Lord. And the second thing is to obtain compassion for the fellow living entities so we can give them Krishna consciousness. So these are the two important things. Acquiring taste for chanting, and the when we have sufficient taste, we want to give it to others. And compassion should drive that. So today's book distribution effort is there. So we should remember all these qualities. We should be tolerant. We should be merciful. We should practice, have strong sadhana. We should leave everyone with good impression. One should feel like this devotee who was agitated, but still he remained composed. And they became life members. So like that, one should influence the hearts of others. One should melt the heart of others by one's character. Dharma sthapana hetu sadhur vyavahara. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says in Chaitanya Charitamrita, one can preach effectively by one's character. The other person changes by looking at your character more than the words that you speak. It touches the person's heart. So one should do all these things. Pray to the Lord, have nice sadhana, and pray for enthusiasm, another important thing. Enthusiasm. Utsahan nischayat dhairyat. And the Lord will reciprocate, either in distributing lot of books or raising lot of funds, flyers, making devotees, all these things will happen. We'll stop here. Any other questions, comments on what we discussed? Okay. Randraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Nitai Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Bol, Hare Krishna.